Fraunhofer Institut. Fraunhofer is actually developing the algorithm together with the University Oldenburg and the Hertech, they employ it. So this year they made the first release of the Open Master Hearing Aid and also spoke about it at the Linux Audio Conference. And just like 1 month ago, the first time it was installed on a Raspberry Pi 3. I got that thing last Thursday and I thought, okay, let's pitch it and see if what people are saying. And I spoke already to a lot of people and a lot of people saying, okay, I have some relatives or myself, I have hearing impairment and I want to have a self-determined, self-fitting hearing aid. Let's start to develop something. So I think it's something gonna grow up. So I'm also on the start of building something up like you were with LibreMesh router, and I think we're gonna do it. So how does it work? You need actually microphones and loudspeakers, and this is special because you have the loudspeakers and the microphones directly on your ear, which means you're able to hear binaural. That means you can locate sounds, which is okay, nice to have anyway, but it won't work on a normal hearing aid anyway. Unfortunately, you need a preamplifier for your microphones and some power plug, and this is a Raspberry Pi with some sound shield. So probably I should tell why I came to this project. It is because I have a hearing impairment myself. I don't hear the higher bands, which is quite normal for half of the people of the world. But usually, even in the West, only half of the people get a hearing aid, and from them, nearly nobody uses it. So why is this? I mean, I can tell it for myself. You get a test in a completely acoustically free room. You get some sinus, and you get some single words. They speak to you, and then they make your audiogram. And then I say, okay, this is bands you don't hear anymore, this is your problem, so this is now what you should hear, and they put it on the hearing aid. They wouldn't explain anything of the algorithm running there. They wouldn't give you any chance to switch your algorithm on or off, or to make some self-fitting. They just tell you, this is now what's good for you. You are impaired. That means we know what you should hear, and that is in the health insurance says you should hear technocratically 90% of normal hearing. That means practically, for me example, I think my hearing loss started when I was around 20, and to be honest, I'm 51 now. That means in 30 years I slowly hear less and less, and I got really used that I don't hear actually birds anymore, that I don't hear a lot of like all the higher bands I don't hear. Now somebody tells me, yeah, you should, because this is normal. Let's normalize people. Let's normalize perception. And this is really a head-banging noise you got in that moment. And they pat you. This is get used to it. It's like for normal hearing people, like you would go to the stereo, take it, everything you get, and say, so here's the laptop, work. Get used to it. It's impossible, you know? I got really fed up, you know? So I had a look for some people also here around to hacking hearing aids, but this is also not really the point, because the design of a normal hearing aid, we didn't change for the last 60 years. Actually, it didn't change for the last 200 years, because in the beginning it was just like you had these mechanical trumpets. You put like headphones on, and then they had transistors, make it a bit smaller, and now they make it even more smaller. You can put it behind your ear, and it's still ugly, and they're still completely unsexy. And this is, and then you have things like, they have, for example, a microphone. You have inside microphone in hard case on the bone of your head. You know what that means? It means dong, dong, ach, ach, hush, hush. This is ugly, you know? And you should, and of course, it has to be invisible. That means it's also the problem with that one. I would say, let's see if you really need it. That means microphone and speaker are really close to each other, very clear what happens, you will have feedback for sure. And then you fight against feedback. Even with this one, you have also this little in the background. It's always, you know. And then you have, for example, directional microphones. You should have. It's a decision of the people who are developing it. That means where I put my head, for example, to you, the microphone, as the algorithm decides, so you are the speaker, and will enhance your voice. You know. Now you probably start to speak a bit louder and say, "Oh, okay, this is important point. Enhance your voice, and I have no chance to understand you anymore." I'm actually not set. When the algorithm is deployed, when does it work? I'm not allowed to switch it off when I don't need it. And this is actually, from the user side, a no-go, you know? And so I made this idea up to make some open design and sound research and for some PhD, but it didn't work out. But I got some connection to Fraunhofer Institute. They said, okay, they like the idea of self-fitting, but closed algorithm. I said, oh, this is not so nice, but I started anyway. And now it came out, okay, we have the open MHA, we have the open hardware, and I said, okay, this is a really nice project, let's push it forward, you know. Okay, this is the main idea behind it from the hardware side. And you would get an image for an SD card, you just copy on it. And they have, this is of the Open MHA, the main algorithm you have already. This is about soft clipping, which it's about if the amplification is overdriven. A binaural coherence filter is a sort of, normalization. And multiband dynamic compression, you can focus on several frequencies you want to have more amplified or less amplified. And a frequency shifter is also something you would probably use also for my here impairment. You shift a bit the higher bands is cut, and you shift it to the bands you can still hear. And then please give me the chance to regulate it, because when I put the hearing aids on, it's like you have like a double higher bands pushing. That means, you know, the higher bands which are shifted to the normal bands I'm hearing, and this is double this. It looks like out of a tin, you know, and that's normal hearing aid sound. That's why I think self-fitting is the most important thing. So what I'm gonna work for this citizen science project now for 2 years, and that means now in the first phase, in the next month, we're gonna have more of these prototypes, also around 6-7 prototypes, you know, and it's still like half running, and it's we're gonna make some self-fitting, which might be interesting for you, because the Raspberry Pi will make a network, and you can connect to it through SSH, which I did for this one. And then you get this, you will start for the graphical user interface some MATLAB thing or Octave, which is open source. Then you can start the MHA control. And then you can do actually the fitting from your computer without having with the graphical user interface, but without taking resources from the Raspberry Pi, which I find quite chic. This is, for example, my hearing cough has also some blast trauma because of playing drums, I guess. Somebody told me. Anyway, this I wanted to show you. The fitting, genau, that's how it looks like. And then you can do your fitting, listen to it. makes the different bands have, and then can load different plugins. You can write your own plugins. It's in C++ at the moment. Should probably transfer to Faust, which is kind of more easy to understand. And there should be some new API that you, even if you're not like deeply into this development, you can somehow speak to the software. And this will be done hopefully in the next month too. We're gonna have some evaluation about what people really like to hear. So that's actually the name of the project, hear what you like to hear. And then we're gonna have a hackathon in July in Berlin. I invite you all to take part. Would be lovely. So if you want to take part, wait, this was the wrong direction. This is our list. I'm gonna make any announcements on this list. Just get part of it. There's also the possibility. Possibilities of a lot of other plugins for the OpenMHA, which you can run on your computer or run on the Raspberry, or however you want. You know, I have it also installed on my computer. It's running with an external audio card. I mean, the main problem is really the delay. What I found really amazing is that they made it really run on the Raspberry with no delay. I had some people testing it. And it was only one person saying, hey, some strange kind of echo. I don't really know. I say, okay, this must be delay. I don't hear it. I mean, okay. So this is, I will learn about it and I will break it out for non-scientific users of programmers for the hearing aid and bring it to the next hackathon in July. And yeah, if you want to come more into the technology part. There was this talk at the Linus Audio Conference 2017, and this is a video of it. So, okay, that was it from my side. Do you have any questions about it? What I really thought, what about MHA is also a question I had already bring into discussion is that you could like mesh the hearing aids, you know, make it run and like exchange your presets, you know. That was instead of bringing to cloud anything, make it personal and mesh it directly, you know. So you stand, for example, at the traffic crossing, and you just have a look if somebody is in the neighborhood who has the perfect preset for that crossing or for that concert or for this room, you know. You can just mesh it all around, you know. That was the idea, and it should run on it, shouldn't it? And OLSR is actually running on the Raspberry, and we need just a good antenna. Yeah, man, we could use that Libre router antenna and make really cool stuff out of it. What do you think? Yeah, let's make a project out of it. Cool. Yeah, this is the input from my side. Do you have questions? Where is the microphone?
Hello? The prototype, like these seven prototypes that you mentioned, are to replace the Raspberry, or I didn't fully get what is the point of the, or what's the function of the prototypes?
The function of the prototype is, this is actually the prototype, so Raspberry is a prototype, yeah. And it is that you make self-fitting in real sound environments, not in these laboratories like sound, all noise in, excluding environments, which is artificial and doesn't reflect the real situation. It's also the only situation where a hearing aid makes sense. If I go to a talk, for example me, I understand the speaker, but I don't understand the people asking questions usually. And there, in that situation, you have no extra noise. It's like in the test situation, no extra noise. It doesn't make so much difference where the noise comes from, because binaural hearing is also a problem with hearing aids. And that it works, but it doesn't work in a situation like this. I would never put it on because it will amplify all the surround noise. It's really like, you know, it's really going to into your head. And this is the idea is, go with this. I'm going to make meetups with people with and without hearing impairment, because already now we realized you hear more relaxed. Even with normal hearing, you start to you can more clear sound and you hear relaxed. So where is the difference between relaxed hearing and the moment it gets smoky, let's say, you can't really understand anymore, and you know. So let's go out with people with and without hearing impairment, go into concert, go into traffic, go into public transport, come here, go into cinema, into restaurant, and make yourself fitting. Collect the data, evaluate it, and give it to the community. That's the idea. And then we decide, with all this algorithm, which algorithm, how the fuck do they work? You know, I want to learn it. Do I really need them? Do other people like them? Then you make a nice small collection of algorithms we want, which are making sense to us, and in the way they are making sense to us. So with some probably idea of self-fitting. Is this a sign of this heaven? Or and then we can decide how we want to develop hardware for it. That's okay. The way. Okay, that's for what it's for. Bring it out of the laboratory to the people. And then, at the end, we're gonna make some art exhibition. I invite you all to take part with some ideas in about 2 years. Contact me. I'm open for all kind of crazy, deployment or just don't know what. About hearing. What does it mean? What does in the sense of wellness? Because I think it's not about to reach in a technocratic way the normalized hearing. What does it mean? What does normalizing mean at itself? You know, it for culture and everything. We should leave diversity like it is, accept it, and that's how it is, and get into wellness. Hear what you like to hear for everybody. Do what you like to want to do. You know, that's about and. So in a way it's about technology, but it's in another way it's also about human beings. What do they want to do out of it? Bring it to the community. Yeah. Thank you for listening.